All right, here we go. The top 10 Raw moments for the 11th of January, 2021.
Didn't want to accept your challenge. You challenging me, that's like you challenging yourself in your prime. Would you honestly want to fight yourself in your prime?
Why would he, right?
But then, my opinion changed when you put your hands on me.
Yeah.
Seems like you're the one that needs a lesson of respect, though. If that's what you want.
Man.
It's Goldberg.
Don't know about this match.
And in your own words,
talk about this later on.
Or the Royal Rumble. You're next.
Already did he end this matchup, but he also ended his losing streak. It's his first win in like, I don't know, how many matches. Good on him, man. You should kill this feud already now, you know what I mean? Kind of went back to it. Guys are being, you know, pretty cheeky with each other, you know.
Sheamus and Keith Lee win. Here are your winners, the team of Keith Lee and Sheamus.
So about the guys in this generation, how they punch, man. They pack a punch, man. They pack a wallop, but.
The gigantic Amos.
I said why now it's pronounced that way. It's weird.
Associate of AJ Styles. Oh, backed up the phenomenal one for months. And again, that just the impact of the mere presence of Amos. And now Styles in position.
Here we go.
Phenomenal form. Down goes
Talk about
Gulak.
This still.
Styles into the cover.
Confusing.
And there goes Gulak.
How they write certain things.
And now Keith Lee.
Yeah. This came out from the tag team match. You're like, these guys are getting along. All of a sudden they come back on break. And they're going at it. No explanation. Nothing. Letting us know as to why it happened, you know that they have this, you know, stuff, you know, that bit of a rivalry between them, you know, animosity, if you will. Riddle solved. He wasn't going to win the title.
That is a scary display of power.
That's terror made flesh.
Which kind of makes, this makes, Lashley relevant having that title. You know.
And look at this.
But you're gonna keep it on him.
The official sees this one clearly. It's over. Here's your winner by submission, and still the United States champion, Bobby Lashley.
This here, why? Why? It's like, yes, everybody knows that they're both married, and why are they together in a thing? But yeah, remember that when that happened, man? This is like, even look at Keith Lee, you know.
I can't believe that just happened.
Just skip that Ric Flair thing, whatever. I don't care. I really don't care. That's pretty good right here, man. She knows how to do that whole you know, what do you call that? Fireball. Now there are some takeaways that I got from this Raw. We saw it open with Triple H. He comes on, pretty much he's going to handle business, right? Corporate side, you know, that's why he's there. Randy Orton comes out, pretty much punks him out. Triple H was like, you know what, you should know better than to let something like that get you into a point of you having to accept a challenge like that. He's walking off, and then all Randy Orton had to do was just make a comment about Stephanie. You know, too bad Stephanie ain't here so that you can't go to her and get your balls from her purse. Triple H is smarter than this. He's a cerebral assassin. He's gonna then eventually say, okay, I accept your challenge for a street fight. Why? Nobody wants to see Triple H anymore. He even said he's no longer gonna even compete or anything. It should include a street fight. Then was I glad to see him back? No. Who cares? You know, behind the scenes, you know, NXT. You know, like, what did this do for Raw, for the ratings? Did they use this as a way to get the ratings back up? Another legend, Triple H has won, right? He accepted the challenge because he did it for the legends. When does Triple H ever care about them? His character, I'm talking about, not Paul Levesque, not him. You know what I mean? Didn't he kind of beat around on some legends too? You know, old timers. You know what I mean? I mean, he cares about them more than Randy Orton, of course. So Randy Orton don't give a fuck, but you know. And then how it ended, you know, the whole thing you saw, with the fireball, which. Got to give her credit. She did it. But who was the one that botched that thing? It was Hogan, right? And Hogan tried it in, what's that, WCW, right? But we just see Alexa. I thought we were going to see The Fiend, but I guess The Fiend's going to be saved for probably WrestleMania. I mean, not WrestleMania, Royal Rumble. Now, let's move on from that. Let's go to qualifying for the Royal Rumble. You know, back in the day, these guys had to qualify. Matches, right? Now, let's talk about how Drew Gulak says, hey, I want a spot in the Royal Rumble. I declare myself. I would like to have number 30, but I know that's not possible. And then Adam Pearce, in his infinite wisdom, right? Oh, you know, you can't just declare yourself. You got to qualify. So, we're going to have you take on AJ Styles. AJ Styles beats him. So, it's a no-go. He doesn't qualify. Gee. Now, all these guys are like declaring themselves, right? They don't have to qualify. Drew Gulak couldn't do that because I guess he's a lower mid-card guy. He's not the guy that's in the thrust of a main push or something like that, so he can't just declare himself. He's not one of the top tier guys. Oh, but Dana Brooke and Mandy Rose declared themselves, and that's okay. No qualifying match for them. Does that make any sense? Really? Does that make any fucking sense? No, it doesn't. It doesn't. Does WWE think that we're so feeble-minded and simple-minded that we didn't see that we just saw Drew Gulak have to qualify and then turn around, and then not in the next or a couple of seconds later we see Dana Brooke and Mandy Rose, we declare ourselves for the Royal Rumble. You know what I mean? They had three effing weeks, man. Fucking weeks. Yeah, 3 fucking weeks. I think we had 4 before that. I think we had a full month. These guys could have had some qualifying matches, some Royal Rumble, battle royal type matches, anything to qualify. You know? But no, right? Confusing. Then again, it shouldn't be because it's WWE. Now, how about Goldberg? Last week. And I didn't catch this because I was just so disgusted. He comes on, right? And he says that Drew McIntyre has disrespected the legends. Disrespected, right? That's how the rivalry between him and the feud between him and Randy Orton really heated up is when he did what he did, when Randy Orton did to what he did week after week, punt kicking Christian, Big Show, you know, and Ric Flair. And then they have Oldberg come in, and it's written for him that he has to say that, oh, well, we gotta have a rivalry build up. We gotta have something there so that it'll make it like Randy Orton. I mean, Drew McIntyre and him, Goldberg, there's a reason why they're gonna go at it. Oh, let me just say that he disrespected the legends. Like, you know what would have been a better thing for Royal Rumble? How about Goldberg comes in, he singles out Randy Orton, tells him, you've been disrespecting the legends, but I'm active. You know, I'm signed to WWE, and I have a match at Royal Rumble. And because you disrespected legends, some of them my friends, I want you. You're next. And then he beats Randy Orton, and then he becomes the number one contender. He gets a shot at, they could have even done that night, where he earns that shot, and then later on that night he challenges Drew, and then Randy Orton can still go on to face the Fiend, because I believe that's what's going to happen. He's going to face the Fiend at Royal Rumble. They're just going to give him a title shot just because he has two matches, contracted matches a year, and so he's going to go after the main title. And this is the only title that he's not gotten. He's won the WCW. In WCW, he's a world champion. He won the big gold belt when it was in WWE. He's won the Universal title. He's never won the WWE title. Even Drew McIntyre brought that up. See, that was the better scenario. Instead of the inane, oh, I'm gonna, I don't appreciate that you disrespected the legends. He didn't disrespect the legends. When did Drew McIntyre disrespect the legends? That's such, you know, what do you call it? Such bad writing. But like I said, WWE, I think they think that we're stupid, that we're feeble-minded, that we don't remember. Well, that's only like a few weeks back, a month back, a couple months back. Yeah, we remember WWE. We remember that it was Randy Orton that was punt-kicking everybody, and Drew McIntyre came to their aid and went after Randy Orton because of that. It's stupid. You know, and then I've talked about how Goldberg's like Oldberg. I keep saying Goldberg. He's Oldberg. Oldberg, like, he's like going, oh, you know, I'm not here to demand anything. And then he turns it around and says, I want a title. I want a shot at your championship. And it's ridiculous, man. This is silliness. And this is how they, you know, want to build up to the Royal Rumble. It's the road to WrestleMania. But you want the possibility of Goldberg main eventing WrestleMania? Of course, probably won't happen because it's probably going to be Roman Reigns that's going to main event. I mean, I can't recall the WWE Championship even main eventing. Maybe the last time was at WrestleMania 31, maybe. I was there, you know. But usually it's the Universal title. Especially because Brock Lesnar had a stranglehold on the belt. But the writing on SmackDown, I mean on Raw, really did not make any sense. Like, you know, it's just awful. You know, I don't get it. The whole thing with Goldberg, it just does not make any sense. Going after Drew McIntyre because he disrespected the it's Randy Orton. And how about you earn your title shot, you jackass, you old man? Like, coming here to WWE and then you just usurp or you take the spot from the younger guys. I'm not one of these guys that go, oh, he's old, he shouldn't be. If it makes sense, yeah, sure. And Drew McIntyre better win. And if he doesn't, he's just another victim. KO is slowly but surely getting back his footing now. But he really took, him and The Fiend, really took a big, you know, slide when they lost and gave up their championships to Goldberg. Give me a break. Then you're gonna do this to him, who supposedly Drew McIntyre is the future. He's the one that's the face of the company, and they're gonna have him drop it. They better not have him drop it. How about Goldberg? Hey there, Bill. How about you do the deed and you put him over? You pass the baton, the torch, to Drew. Don't be so selfish. But man, that's all I gotta say about Raw. I mean, did I enjoy anything? I mean, I like the team of Keith Lee and Sheamus. I like the banter. I like the back and forth. I like how they were joking with each other, and then of course the explosion or part of the ring collapsing, the ropes kind of snapping. They're able to get it fixed, and then the match continued, and then they're impromptu like one-on-one match, and then after that they were cool again. That's the only thing I liked, you know. Everything else was a lot of just mishmash and confusion and what and scratching my head. It's like, but it's Raw, of course. We all know that, right? Raw always leaves us with a what, you know, what the F kind of thing, you know, what the fuck. But anyway, that's my video for Raw. The top 10 Raw moments for 11th of January 2021. And well, for those of you who stopped by, checked out this video, I appreciate it. And in closing, as always, take care.